in my arms, I held a world of charms. 11:30 Saturday night. At 8, my face had just begun.
Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome. I'm very, very happy to see everyone in person. I'm mic'd, which feels a little strange at Farbrook, but I think it's going to help the live stream, so thank you for that. We have been celebrating together with this processional since our beginning, since our founding in 1948. So it feels like a tradition that we've been holding on to and value. We revisit it every year and always come back to it for its beauty, for its simplicity, for its service, and for an opportunity for us to take a pause and to be together. So I want to thank you all for being here today. We are really at our best when we partner, and over the processional and the weeks before, we've been partnering with Isaiah House. And I'm very happy that Gianna Santelli, Isaiah House's development director, is here with us. We have had a partnership with Isaiah House for 18 years. And it has become more and more meaningful to our work, to our mission, to our school values. I think you can see here what you all have been a part of, and the kids have brought more food in the hall, and of course, all the beautiful fruits and vegetables that they've been carrying. It feels like a bountiful harvest this year, but it also is a reminder that across the country, in neighborhoods very close to us, around the globe, there are empty cupboards. And so today and this week, it's an opportunity for us to make a difference, a small difference, but maybe a very meaningful difference. So I want to thank the families afterwards, and the faculty and administration will be packing everything up and taking it to Isaiah House. And hopefully this week, making it a more meaningful, a hopeful, a nourishing Thanksgiving for some of our families. A couple of things before we start. No one likes this, but I'm going to ask you to put your cell phones away and ringers off and everything. It's a moment for you, I hope, to take a pause. I know how busy your lives are. I know how connected we are to our phones. I always try to find out where my teenagers and 21-year-old son is on my phone, but I left it on my desk, so whatever's going on in their worlds, they're going to be okay. Take a moment for yourselves to pause, to take a deep breath, and to just sit back and hear beautiful music and see your beautiful children. So if I can ask you for that, that would be great. We've had some amazing volunteers. I laugh that this is a non-regulation basketball court most of the year, and now it's turned into a beautiful room for us to experience processional together. So thank you to Liz Burke, to Mark Unferth, Carolyn Albert, and a whole team of people who came here last weekend to transform it. And Rob, I see Rob, thank you. This is Rob, so thank you, it's beautiful. Every time I come in, I think, wow. And I love it for the kids because they haven't been here, so Monday they came in and some of the littlest of our students sort of walked in and looked around and stopped, dropped a potato maybe. And it was really wonderful to see them be part of this. For many years, Nursery Threes stayed in their classrooms. And when Haruka came, she's like, let's have the Nursery Threes do this. And it's actually one of the sweetest part of the day. Amanda Richardson and the PCC team helped us both days, yesterday and today, with coffee. So thank you for warming us up today. To our professional musicians, thank you for your commitment to Farbrook, for coming here year after year, and for your beautiful, beautiful music. I know it's a holiday week, and you're really taking time to be with us. And so thank you for bringing your beauty and your talent to Farbrook. I want to thank Arismia and her team, Peter, Milan, and Karen. If you could stand, Arismia, Milan. Peter is somewhere, Karen is somewhere, but there. This is our amazing music team, and I have watched them. You know them. Who pushes, Ed, who pushes the boulder up the hill? There we go. It's a little bit like that, heading into it. But the product is gorgeous. And when I see our music team, what they do with the kids day in and day out to bring us here today, it's extraordinary. And thank you for keeping music really part of our core value here at Farbrook and the fabric of what we do. Many other schools, music is an add-on, music is a choice. Every student from nursery threes through eighth grade is part of our music program. And so every student you will see up here didn't make a choice to do it, is part of a group. And I always say that we're stronger as a group than we are as individuals. So thank you for keeping music alive at Farbrook. Before our last song, Arismia will invite us all to sing, The Earth Shall Yield. The lyrics are in your program. I'd ask you to hold your applause until the final song, until the students are walking out, but please applaud. In the old days, it was silence until they left, and we realized the students never heard any affirmations, so it's a really nice way to applaud them. And then I ask that you could remain seated until the orchestra is done with the final note of Processional, because it's a beautiful, beautiful piece of music. Finally, as we head into this holiday week, I want to thank all of you. I want to thank this remarkable, remarkable community, students, families, alumni, faculty, administrator. You inspire me and you encourage me every single day. I witness random acts of kindness and incredible expressions of generosity and joy and love every single day. And I've said this a few times, I think when you string those acts of kindness and acts of generosity together, you get what I call humanity. So I want to thank you for being part of this community, for the school we love so much. My motto is find joy where you can. And so this week, find joy, have a very, very happy Thanksgiving, and I appreciate all of you.
Thank you. my name.